Hey guys, it's me, Pokemon. I'm here to talk about what NetMarble could do to fix this situation. So with this premium hero chest, or the ultimate chest, there was no easy way to fix this. They've added something that only whales bought, or new players invested a ton of money in. So if they throw them at us now, easier to get, like the ultimate characters, if they make them easier to get, now you've made the whales mad. But they can't leave the ultimate chest there because it makes everybody else mad. So they're in this weird place, and I think that's why they're taking a while to get back to us. So I'm going to talk a little bit about what I'd want to see from them for next patch in order to regain my trust, sort of. I'd like to see the ultimate chest gone, and I'd like to see a new way to get the characters that doesn't count the lab, because the lab is horrible. I got enough bios to unlock them, which was only 10 bios. I'd already been down 400 Norn Stones. It's ridiculous how much it costs. I used Mega Rank Up tickets on them then that I already had. It'd be nearly impossible to get them to Tier 2 naturally like that. So first, what I'd like them to do is to slow down with adding characters. Stop raising the bar of power level. Stop raising the crazy thing this character can do. And go back and let's fix what we have already. There's a lot of characters in this game that just suck right now. They're just not good at all. They don't compare to other characters in the game. And I'm going to go over some of those characters. So we're just going to run down the whole list. I'm going to mention characters that I think need buffed or changed. Captain America, pretty good place. Age of Venom, good. Wolverine, good. Apocalypse, good. Hulk. I'd like it if they buffed the base version of Hulk a bit more. I don't like it when the only viable version of a character is their uniform. I don't think normal Hulk's all that great. And now I'm sure there's going to be somebody in the comments that when I mention a character's bad, they'll be like, but Pokemon, I'm good with this character. I'm not counting, like, you know, Hulk's number one fan in the world who spent all his time investing in this character, or some Korean player who's really good at this game. I'm talking about an average Joe like me who just logs into the game, bashes the skills effectively, and what I'm capable of doing with the character. So Hulk, I don't think he's that good without a uniform. With a uniform, he's really good. Black Panther, I know some people can do good with him, but I think he could definitely use a buff. He's going to get one soon with the new Black Panther movie coming out, but I feel it'll be a lot like Hulk and Venom, where also like Venom, where Venom is bad, but when he gets his anti-Venom costume, he's pretty good. But I don't like it how base Venom's still really bad, and I feel like Black Panther's going to end up having that problem. She-Hulk, pretty bad, except for her leadership, but she's not that great of a character otherwise. I think Titania's fine. Sif, I think, could use a buff. I don't think she's all that great. Pretty low damage. Lizard, he's not bad where he is. He's not exactly great, but we can live with how Lizard is. Beast, he's pretty good. Groot's good with his costume, and I think he serves a nice niche as a healer, but I think he could definitely use more defense to maybe be a little bit more of a tank. Scourge, he's fine. White Tiger could maybe use a little bit of a DPS buff, but not necessarily needed. Warwolf has a great passive, and he can help out his team without actually fighting, but he's pretty bad in terms of actually fighting. Hulkbuster, also pretty bad. Fell victim to power creep. Used to be really great back in the day. Used to be Silk, Hulkbuster, and Loki were meta, and then, you know, everything happened. Moon Knight, he's fine. Iron Fist, he's fine. I think base Iron Fist could use a bit of a buff. He's pretty good with his hobo Iron Fist costume, but he's not that great on his own. Punisher, I think he'd use a bit of a buff. I really like him with his costume, but he's not all that great without it. But I think when he has his costume, he's a pretty fine character. Jessica Jones needs tons of help. Super boring kit, super slow. They could speed everything up that she has by 2 and then double her health and she'd still be bad. Nebula could use a bunch of help. Hulkling could use a good amount of help. I don't know if Hulkling is one of the most needy characters, but it's more like nobody cares about Hulkling. I don't think anybody's been like, yes, Hulkling, I'm so glad he's in this game. Shang-Chi, he's not bad, but again, kind of forgettable. Blade needs a massive buff. He's horrible in the game right now. Sandman, he's pretty good. Red Hulk, without his costume, maybe a little iffy, but he's pretty okay, especially when he has his costume. Same for Luke Cage, he's pretty okay, and he has a nice niche with reflecting physical damage. At least I believe it's physical damage. It might be energy damage. Bullseye, pretty bad. Deathlok, pretty bad. Giant Man, really bad. Hulk, Amadeus Cho, when he doesn't have his costume. When he does have his costume, he's pretty great. Kingpin, pretty with and without his costume. Crossbones, pretty with and without his costumes. Gorgon's pretty. I'm trying to make the mess sound, but I'm getting tired of making the mess sound. There's a lot of mech characters in this game, guys. But he has an excellent leadership. Ulick, I haven't played him enough. But he has a nice, like, passive against heroes, so he tends to actually be really great, at least in Alliance Conquest. Dr. Octopus, probably use a little bit of a buff, the base version of him, but when he has a superior Spider-Man uniform, again, still not all that great, but he's at least usable. Volstagg, he's usable. Hogan's usable. Green Goblin, oh, they count him here because he has a costume that makes him combat. He's pretty bad with and without the costume. American Chavez, I believe she's good. Haven't got to play her a lot. Ms. Marvel's not the worst in the game, but she could use everything. She's pretty bad, and Drax is disgustingly bad. So let's hop over to the Speed Heroes. So I think we all know Quicksilver, Spider-Man, and Spider-Man. They're all really great. Vulture, he's pretty good. I don't know what he's like without his costume, because I almost never used him without his costume. I bought his costume immediately. Ant-Man, he could use some damage. He's definitely fallen victim to power creep, where he used to be really great because of all his iframes, but iframes aren't enough nowadays, especially when you can penetrate iframes. Groot has his little baby Groot costume that turns him into a blast, or a speed, and he's really good with it. Agent 13, horrible. Gwenpool, she's pretty good. Silk, pretty good, but has fallen a little bit victim to power creep, but still pretty good. Kid Kaiju, pretty good. Black Widow, she's not bad. She's pretty okay. Elsa Bloodstone, pretty good, but only with her uniform, but she's still mediocre without the uniform. Spider-Gwen, really bad. Rogue, pretty good. Miles Morales, not that great. I think they could buff Miles Morales, no problem. Black Cat, horrible. Winter Soldier, horrible. Daredevil, horrible. Misty Knight, I don't know, nobody cares about Misty Knight. Gamora, horrible. Elektra, very mediocre. Hawkeye, horrible. Squirrel Girl, she's not bad. Red Skull, horrible. Falcon, horrible. Kate Bishop, she's pretty good. Yondu's pretty good, at least when he has his costume. Base Yondu, not all that great. Mockingbird, horrible. Kraven, I hear good things about him. Hellcat, I don't know what she's like. I guess she's kind of boring, though. Miss Marvel has a costume that turns her into speed, but I still haven't heard that many great things about it. Then we have Sin. I don't think it hurt if they buffed her. I don't think anybody's ever thought Sin was that strong. Karnak, not bad, but could definitely use a buff. Wong, again, he could definitely use a buff. Phandral, he could probably use a buff. Now let's hop on over to Blast Heroes. Captain America, Sharon Rogers, amazing. Inferno, pretty good with his costume. Of course, you have Scarlet Witch, Doctor Strange, Jean Grey, Cable, of course they're great. Moon Girl, she's in an interesting place with a lot of CC. She's not bad, but I don't think anybody would complain if Moon Girl got buffed. Mantis, pretty good. Ironheart, pretty good. Cyclops, pretty good. Enchantress, pretty good. Songbird, I think, could use a buff. She's not bad for working together with teammates, but I think she could use a DPS buff. Lincoln Campbell could use a little bit of everything. He's just pretty bad. Red Skull could definitely use a little bit of everything. Vision, pretty bad. Storm's good. War Machine, pretty bad. Sister Grimm, very mediocre. Yellow Jacket's actually pretty good. Rocket Raccoon's pretty bad. Wasp is pretty good. Iron Man's mediocre. Daisy's really bad, except for one of her boosts. She can give some of her teammates a buff. Wiccan, pretty mediocre, except for the fact that he can help out his teammates by silencing the enemies. Ancient One, not bad, a pretty good healer. Magneto, really good. Star-Lord could definitely use a buff. He's not that great at anything, except for his pretty awesome leadership. Malekith, really bad. Whiplash, nobody cares about. Coulson could definitely use a buff in terms of his damage. He got a uniform, it didn't do much for him. He's a good team player, but on his own, he definitely doesn't have a lot of DPS. Crystal, she's pretty good where she is. Lash definitely could use a buff. He's horrible. MODOK definitely needs a buff. Kingpin definitely needs a buff. Cassilius, he's pretty good where he is, although it wouldn't hurt if they gave him a little more damage. Same thing with Mordo, and maybe a good costume for Mordo. But he's not bad where he is. Mysterio, not bad where he is, but I think he could use a little bit of a DPS boost. Deathlok, bad. Maximus could definitely use a DPS boost. Now let's head over to Universal characters. Thor could use a buff to his base version. He's pretty bad in his base version, but with his most recent costume, he's pretty great. Thanos, of course, is good. Hela could maybe use a bit of a buff, but I don't think she's bad with the most recent costume. Quasar, wouldn't know, not spending money on the game. Anti-Man, ridiculously overpowered. Ghost Rider could definitely use a buff to his base costume. He's not bad with his new uniform, or was new uniform, and then his tier 2 that makes him do bonus damage against supervillains, but I don't think anybody would complain if he got buffed. Loki, base version, could use a little bit of a buff, fell victim to power creep, but he's pretty good with his uniform. Nova, ridiculously overpowered. Klee, I've never seen anybody use Klee. I don't know, I'm sure they could buff her, nobody would care. Ultron, definitely needs a buff. Horrible, he's a really bad character. Robbie Reyes, he's in a pretty good place. Black Bolt, not a bad place. Black Thor, fine where he is. Singularity, could definitely use a buff. Captain Marvel, we had the Ultimates patch. No buff for Captain Marvel, who knows why. She's pretty bad. Supergiant, not bad. Vision, he's pretty bad. Medusa's not bad, but I think she could use a buff to stand up with other characters. Same thing with Satana, she's not the worst, but she could definitely use a little bit of help. Odin, he's, you know, Odin, so of course he's good. Thor Jane Foster could definitely use a little bit of help. She's not bad, but she's not exactly good. Dormammu's good. Blue Marvel's ridiculously good. Heimdall, you know, he's not bad. He has some defense, but I don't think anybody would complain if he got a little buffed. Proxima's good. Corvus is good. Hellstrom's pretty good. Hyperion can definitely use a buff, even considering he's a paywall character. I don't know why Mysterio's under Universal. Ebony Maw's pretty good. Angela definitely could use a buff. And Groot has a uniform that makes him Universal, but he's still bad. The only good version of him is with his speed costume. Then we have Ronan, could definitely use a buff. And I think Destroyer, I don't think anybody complained if he made a buff. Now, if you want to know how I graded this, I kind of considered in PvP, you know, if you were to put him against a Sharon Rogers or something. I mean, Daredevil will never win against Sharon Rogers. Ronan would never win. Maybe a Destroyer, because he has the special advantage. But there's a lot of characters that have just been forgotten completely in the meta because we're getting characters like Nova and Blue Marvel. And if NetMarble, if you guys want to keep on raising that cap as fast as you are, try not to forget about the rest of the characters that you're leaving behind in the dust. And I think that's something that would make me forgive you guys a bit for the Ultimates chest if you fixed a lot of the characters you're leaving behind. Because we have like 140 characters, and maybe like 30 to 40 of them are really good. And it's just, NetMarble is extremely guilty of power creep, and it'd be lovely if they went back and they fixed a ton of their characters instead of adding more characters that just made the rest of the characters even more relevant. So, I'll talk to you guys later. Goodbye, everybody. They keep things loose, they keep things alive.